Hey everybody, today's video is on the cardinal air sign of Libra. In these videos, I will be mostly talking about your sun sign, but if you have a moon and rising in this sign, that also matters. If you have a placement of this sign in the 5th, 6th, or 7th house, this video might also apply to you. I will be paying special attention to the love planet of Venus, which I refer to as bottom energy, and the passionate planet of Mars that I refer to as top energy.
In astrology, there are four elements:
fire, earth, air, and water. Within each of the elements, there are three signs. And for each of those signs, there's three different modes that they could be in: cardinal, fixed, and mutable. The cardinal signs are Aries, Capricorn, Libra, and Cancer. They kick off the season. They're instigators. They incite change. The fixed signs are Leo, Taurus, Aquarius, and Scorpio. They maintain the systems. They're very self-contained. The mutable signs are Sagittarius, Virgo, Gemini, and Pisces. They reconfigure the systems and they're very adaptable to change.
You know what was interesting is I noticed that Libra, the only sign that whose symbol is inanimate, it literally has no life. It must be manipulated by some other force. And that's kind of describing our cardinal air sign Libra and bringer of the fall perfectly. So they're ruled by Venus, which means they are lovers, not fighters. And they hate confrontation. Well, that's what makes them feel like more indecisive, because they would prefer not to have a confrontation with you about it. What Libra is known for is success, and they are known for their fairness, hence the scales. So mindful and cooperative though, that sometimes it can come off as a little bit codependent, or as I had mentioned earlier, conflict avoidant. They are born switches. They love to serve, and Libras in particular love to put on a show. They are the thought-provoking jokesters. They like to be the life of the party, but they want you to remember them, so they want to provoke some sort of thought and understanding in their interaction with you. They love to experience different kinds of relationships, kind of collect different parts of their relationships. It's any kind of relationship, not just romantic, friends, family, even enemies for that matter. And then they make certain parts that they admire their own. They have a strong desire to be liked. As an example, they will overbook themselves, like four different things, because they don't want to make anybody upset. But at the same time, they'll be sitting at home, like watching their fourth episode of the fifth season of something, and their friend will be texting them like, where are you? Oh, but you didn't go because you just wanted to make sure it was yes, and you didn't think that they would even notice that you weren't there. But at the same time, you want them to notice that you're not there. You tell everybody yes, and if you don't show up, they worry about you, or they notice that you're not there. The other part of the Libra, the dark side of the Libra, they are subconscious manipulators. The difference is that their manipulation tends to be for good, or what they think is for good, not evil. They don't have evil intentions. They like to watch and absorb, react, watch, absorb, react, and then a cycle of that. They're going to absorb, again, those characteristics that they want to implement into their life and cast away any of the other ones. Not only are they a little nosy, they have issues with personal space. Like, most Libras are like naturally beautiful. Libras love to be in front of the camera. They love to be entertaining. They want to be the center of attention. They can pride themselves, in fact, in their style and their beauty. It's a big thing for them. Now, I will say that while they come off as very beautiful naturally, they can be a little dirty. And I believe this is my take on that. And for me, it's for Libra, it's the high contrast and that attention grab. So if they're kind of down and dirty a little bit, and then they glow up, it hits you hard. It hits you hard, and it makes you be like, oh, who's that? That's what they want. That's their balance working for them. They have heart hunger and mind hunger, and they're looking for that balance. Most Libras are very creative, and then they need something else to balance that out. So that's that heart and that brain. Libras are the ones in the sex shop that are like this. They literally walk in like, oh my God, look at all of these. I don't even know where to start. How many different kinds do they have? Oh my God. I mean, what do you think? How many kinds do you think there are here? Do you think I could possibly try all of them? Do you think that they have a taster? Like a taster bar? So what about Venus in Libra? Well, it's in its home there. Libra rules Venus. So it's not really overwhelming love that you're gonna get. It's more like a intuitive pursuit. I mean, they have no problem coming up and telling you that they're into you. That's why my nickname for Venus in Libra is Real Love. Mary J. Blige, if you're receptive to their forwardness, then they will adapt and be exactly what you love. It's a balance. If you reject them, they will become repulsed by you. I will say that they do this repulsion thing because it's to protect themselves, but they're still gonna be concerned whether or not you hate them. They won't want you to hate them, but they will have no problem being cold and talking shit. None. They want the storybook idea. I mean, they're ruled by Venus, so they know how to love, and they like to talk about it and talk about it and talk about it because they're an air sign. Harmony is so important to them, and they will work to explain things into balance. This placement, it just loves people. And so it will explain how that person fits into the balance of their life. They're excellent at that. It's not about attraction. In fact, the more unbalanced that somebody appears to them, and that doesn't mean, I don't mean mentally unbalanced. I'm not saying that. Like, something in their life is not balanced. They need help in something. Libras are on that. So they want to be your anchor to help balance you out. And they will always play your devil's advocate. They will be your hero, whatever you need them to be. And their placement, they're either very sweet or they're an asshole. And that can be within the same hour. It just kind of depends on the day. When Mars goes into Libra, kind of one of the most self-deprecating positions, this is a tough spot. They really hate confrontation in general, who have a non-confrontational sign in a very confrontational planet. They don't know how or where to put their anger and aggression. And so they're very analytical about their anger, and then they use that to help others find balance. Because they'll get angry, they'll analyze it, and then when somebody else has that reaction, they can then explain, because they're an air sign, how to work through that anger. Like, they have no idea how to deal with anger themselves, for themselves, but helping other people balance out, into it. That's why my nickname for Mars and Libra is Even Love. If they show anger at all, it's going to be verbally, because again, they're an air sign. They're probably going to attack you. I mean, don't be surprised if they get angry and they call you some sort of name or something. They're gonna apologize immediately after. I'm just gonna give them a minute. They don't want you to be upset with them. And they don't know how to deal with their anger, and it just pops out, and then they feel upset because they don't have it balanced. So give them a moment to rebalance themselves. When it comes to being in a relationship with somebody who has a Mars in Libra, they're very passive aggressive in the bedroom, but that plays into their strong switch vibe. Porn switches, they wanna please, and they very much enjoy pleasing you. Now, they are prepared for you to please them as well. It's, again, balance. They're quite playful though. So they like role playing and games. And they also like serious and intense pleasure. Are there any famous Libras out there? It was hard to narrow this down, I'll tell you that. I'm just gonna start out with my super Libra, just five or more placement. Natalie Maines.
From the Chicks.
Sun and Venus in Libra, Will Smith and Bai Ling. Sun and Mars in Libra, Brie Larson and Zac Efron. Sun placement of Libra, there's Halsey, Donald Glover, AKA Childish Gambino, Serena Williams, Bruno Mars, Cardi B, and Ezra Miller. Venus in Libra, Emma Stone, Freddie Mercury, Beyonce, and Adam Driver. Mars in Libra, King Princess, Frank Ocean, Janelle Monáe, Kate McKinnon. So in summary, it's difficult for Libras to make decisions. They want to make everybody happy, and even if it's by sacrificing their own identity. Encourage your Libra partners to self-reflect, and when they compliment themselves on that rare occasion, make sure you encourage that. And if you do have a Libra partner, they don't care very often. If they care for you, show them that you appreciate them, and show it often. Next, we have one of my favorites, Scorpio. This has probably been the most requested video that's coming up, and we only have two left, so we're coming in hot at the end with two amazing signs. All right, everybody, until next time, cheers. For all of you that tuned in to this particular video out of all the videos, because you know how I feel about Libras. Hi. I'm not a fan of Libras. I'm sorry to Libras. That's not true. The problem is I'm very drawn to Libras, and I like them a lot at first. Then they drive me crazy. I can't handle it. I cannot handle it. I'm too efficient and they are too indecisive. So that ends up rubbing the wrong way. So like in the dating world, on the dating apps or we're chatting, just know that if you're a Libra, you already have two strikes, one more and you're out. I'm sorry. I mean, I'm not sorry, but I'm sorry if you're offended by me being offended. Anyway, you know, like a lot of my favorite rappers are also Libras. There's so many, I couldn't put all of them there. Eminem's a Libra, Snoop Dogg's a Libra. There's more, there's so many more. It's awesome. Your mom's a Libra. Oh my God! They're walking around holding all these different packages, and they're just walking around the store and they're like, let me see something else. Like, what if I want to do some butt